This might come as a shock, but God's purpose for you is not merely that you go to heaven when you die. Actually, God's purpose is for all creation, and what He really wants is total restoration. For you, yes, but also for the whole world.
Everything you see exists together in a delicate balance.
In order to join Jesus in His resurrection life, we have to be willing to die to ourselves and our old ways of living and thinking. The thing is, we don't do anything to be saved, but because we're saved, we've been saved for something, not just from something.
Well, I see things differently now.
So what does a restored, resurrected life in Jesus actually look like? Well, once again, Jesus Himself is the key. He showed us that a resurrected life looks like service in humility to the whole world.
Your Majesty, I am your humble servant.
But who do we serve exactly? And how much do I have to sacrifice for this mission? Well, honestly, that's going to be a little bit of a different answer depending on the person. It depends on how God has gifted you and how He's called you. We'll get to that later. But here's one thing that's universal. We are all called to participate in God's mission to the entire world. In Matthew, Jesus tells us that our mission is to disciple all nations, not just our local area. So we've got to participate in this global idea.
Actually, habitable worlds right within our reach.
So wait, does that mean that we're literally all called to be overseas missionaries and go somewhere strange where they've never heard the gospel, devote our whole lives to just that? Well, of course not. But all of us can be global in different ways. Here are some examples. First, you could give resources to organizations that help around the world. Second, you could support missionaries in various ways. Third, you could befriend folks from other contexts and cultures. And finally, you could establish international relationships. It's easier now to do that than ever before. Finally, the internet can do something good.
Welcome to the internet.
Have a look around.
But how do we know that any of this hard work is even going to be effective? And frankly, what if we're just bad at it? Well, the good news is that we're not doing this in our own power. God has sent His Holy Spirit to give us the gifts and the skills that we need to do exactly what He is calling us to do. And because He's involved, we know that things are going to be effective, even if not always in the way we expect.
It was totally worth it.
That leads me to my final review point this week, spiritual gifts. But what are spiritual gifts anyway? Well, basically, they are aspects of how the Spirit of God empowers us to participate in His mission to the world. Now, God gives everyone talents and gifts just naturally, but beyond that, He gives Christians supernatural gifts and abilities that are specifically designed to help us accomplish His purposes for His kingdom in the world. These are things that we could only do with God's help. The Bible lists a bunch of different types of spiritual gifts, and we really encourage you to go and look them up for yourselves. So how do I discover my spiritual gifts and figure out how to use them? Well, there's good news. We've got a little bit of a system for you. Here's a method for discerning what your spiritual gifts actually are.
But the method is fascinating.
Step one, examine. What natural passions do you have? What excites you? What are you naturally good at and interested in doing that serves the world? Step two, experiment. Seek opportunities to serve with the gifts you think you might have. Just try it out. And step three, evaluate. Is God glorified in what you're doing? Do you notice the work is effective and edifying for others? How do other trustworthy people respond, especially unprompted, when they see your work? Look to others to confirm that your gifts are indeed what you think they might be. Once you know what your gifts are, there's only one thing left to do. Get your head in the game. Okay, all this is great, but honestly, it's kind of a lot about vocation and ministry in the church and things like that. What about the justice bit? What about serving the poor and the oppressed and those who are vulnerable in society? Isn't that part of this too? Well, the good news is, this isn't the end. We've got service, part two.
There's more?
Simba.
Enjoy the journey.